Hi, I'm Eleanor Hyun. I'm the curator for the Korean Collections. And welcome to my corner. Unlike some people in this museum, Irving, I did not grow up thinking that I would end up working at the British Museum. Perhaps that's logical, being that I was born and raised in New York City to immigrant parents, so the British Museum and even London, working in London, wasn't really on the career path or my future radar. In becoming a curator, even thinking about it, again, not really knowing what that meant when I was 15 years old or 20, it has been, it's an incredible journey that one has to take. And again, these objects, that's what draws me in and that's what fascinates me. And to be able to really think about the objects both accurately and properly, and then to display them in a way that is understandable and decipherable for others, there is a huge amount of background that one must acquire to be able to distill down a story or a narrative. The British Museum is the British Museum, and so it has a reputation and a history that is illustrious and amazing, and then to think that I was going to be part of it is both an honor, but to be really realistic also, you feel a huge responsibility and therefore a little bit of stress. Being responsible for the Korean Collections means being responsible for 6,000 years of history, so from prehistory to the present, on what is the Korean Peninsula in East Asia. And a lot of times, people think museums' displays are permanent. Sort of they get installed, and then they're sort of hermetically sealed, and they'll be the same for about 10 years. Thankfully, for those who work in East Asian art, or any person who has to deal with conservation issues, so particularly works on paper and on textiles, you have to think about conserving the objects so they can't be on view for that long. The Korea Gallery has two rotations a year, so there'll be significant changes made in parts of the gallery because a lot of these objects have to come off view. And that actually makes it really fun because it gives you an excuse when you're sort of caught up with all these other busy things to think about new things to put in the gallery. There are, you know, we have plenty of objects in storage, so why just show the same things? Why not give something else a chance to see the light of day? And so that's really nice, and it actually provides really a great opportunity for me to think about objects that, one, haven't been on view, or two, maybe they have been on view, but thinking about putting them in a different thematic setting. At the moment, I've been planning the next rotation, and the theme is new moons, and it's playing off the fact that the Lunar New Year is fast approaching. And so thinking about the words lunar and new, I thought I would try to create a thematic rotation that dealt with a lot of these new acquisitions that we have, and some of them have not yet been exhibited in the galleries, or so some have yet to been displayed. It's not that you're just sort of come as a curator and you're just left to play with the things that you have, but that you really can think about how these objects speak to contemporary life, but also how there are other objects that help sort of broaden and create a fuller picture of sort of Korean art and society. And so that's really one of the areas that it's actually quite fun because you feel like you're on a scavenger hunt, maybe, that you get to go to places like art fairs and galleries and you see objects and you think, wow, that's an incredible piece. And some things that I'm just personally drawn to, I could see a piece and think, so striking, where it has so much going on that really just draws me in and attracts me. But then I'll think about it and think, one, could this be in the British Museum? And sometimes you really have to think about very practical things. Size, for example. There are pieces that I would love to have, but are just too big for the gallery space, so therefore you can't show it, and so why have it if you can't show it? That I feel like is even sadder, to just be able to have something and just put it in storage the whole time. And then there are other things that you think that are really quite interesting and striking, but how does it relate to the objects that we already have here, and what kinds of narratives are you creating? So then you think about objects and you see them and they're interesting and you realize, oh, this will tell a perfectly links with the object that we have that's from the 17th century, but it's a 21st century artist who is making these links using different kinds of materials. So then you have you sort of fall in love with an object because, one, you think it is incredible as a piece on its own, but then you also see how it makes all these connections and it can really highlight and just illuminate so much more of what's happening, both what had happened in the past, but it's also what's happening now in the present. There's one object recently acquired that really spoke to, I thought, both traditional techniques and materials, but in a very contemporary way. It's a double carved vase, so it means that it's a ceramic piece that has an inner vase and it has also an outer shell, but that's been carved. So it actually looks like sort of a wood carving surrounding or engulfing a ceramic vase. But if you look really closely, it's just really ceramic on ceramic with varnish. So I love that kind of playfulness that he has with taking the ceramics and the ceramic materials, but then adding an element that actually makes one think that it's wood. And I thought that was so beautifully expressed in the piece. And then it also sort of, for me in the British Museum and art collection, it took it one step further because we have an actual lacquer piece, contemporary piece, that looks like a ceramic. So often people think it's just a ceramic piece. So there's this sort of kind of playfulness in materials and how often now artists are using materials in ways so it's not as obvious. So you have a lacquer piece that looks like a ceramic, and now we've just acquired a ceramic piece that looks like lacquered wood. So we'll be displaying them together in the gallery because a lot of the underlying sentiments are the same, and that's, I think, what the beauty of creativity is and how contemporary artists are melding, you know, the past and the present. That was my corner. If I was gonna swap a corner with anyone, it would be Jacob Cooper, because I'd like to learn more about Mesoamerica. Thank you.